the potential. We moved here from Switzerland, and we just wanted something easier, cheaper probably. Switzerland's expensive, I don't know if you've heard. Yeah. What's your job? I'm a freelancer, so I have like multiple little side gigs. What about you? What do you like, are you a digital nomad? Do you want to do it? Oh, so many messages and emails. I'm just like also reviewing my Italian notes. I picked up some Italian. I made a friend who's like refreshing my Italian. So it's really cool. Like, she messaged me in English, she replied to me, but also she said send the exact same message in Italian. Yeah, it's really helpful. It's really cool. It's like, if you want to learn a language, I really recommend doing something like this. Just find someone who speaks the language you want to learn and the language that you can communicate, and you can just like chat, have coffees, lunch, just hang out. So it's like double bill, because you have a friend but also you learn a language. It's cool. No, I'm not. I do CT scanning in the States. You can do CT scanning in Malta. No, you don't want to do that. It's, hospitals here are not most efficient places in the world. They have a good healthcare. It's just, you wait a while. From what I've heard, I've never been. But I want to live abroad. Do it. Nothing's stopping you. Just wondering, how hard is it to be a freelancer and make a living as a nomad? Do you do YouTube? I do podcast with some people from States, funny enough. So, so this is one of the things I do. And I don't know, like, I studied film theory, so I wanted to be a film critic, something completely different. And then, I don't know, you just somehow collect everything you can, and even the things you don't know, like marketing. Like, I've been sort of studying marketing the last few months, and I don't know, things that I've learned in the past somehow translated into marketing, for example, like that I got it, like I really understand the process and, you know, the importance of storytelling, things like that. So my tip would be like, look into everything you know, or and everything you know how to do, and then see where it can sort of translate and stuff. But you can also do something completely different, you know, like, you don't need to do, I don't know, if you do city scanning, it doesn't mean you have to be a photographer. That's a stupid no, but yeah, I don't know, if you used to paint, if you feel like you're creative, you can do a lot with that for sure. But yeah, think about it. What are you good at? What are your skills? What gives you pleasure? Yeah. is there weed in Malta? Hi, Parker. I love name Parker. That is such a cool name. Parker is an awesome name. Yes, there is weed in Malta. They actually legalized it a few months ago. I want to say in January. I'm not quite sure. But yeah, you still need to wait a little bit. So before you come here, you need to wait for like an official information about it. So no, it's not like it's not like in Amsterdam that you go out and you just see everyone with joints and stuff, but it's in the process. Yeah, they legalized cannabis, so Malta's like quite actually, how would you put it, they're very conservative in some things, very family oriented, but at the same time they're very open-minded. It's a very safe place for gay people as well as like drags. Drags can get out of hand here. Like you keep hearing and reading weird news every now and then, but overall it's pretty cool. It's pretty cool place to be. If you're interested, like have a look at places like Sliemars and Julien's. These are probably best choices for digital nomads. My skills are healthcare, but in America the summertime gets super busy. Yeah, your skills are healthcare, but if you go back all the way to school, like were you good at IT or drawing or yeah, because you asked me how do you become a digital nomad. You just specialize in one craft that you can do and you just take it from there. And it's a patient game. You will be rejected a lot. Like I still get rejected all the time for some content writing and stuff. It's very competitive. And when you start doing this, you should be prepared that the world isn't ready for people like us, like digital nomads. It's just not. From like healthcare to Airbnbs, not a lot of places are that friendly for that kind of lifestyle. People expect you to have roots somewhere, which, I mean, not roots, but have a house, yeah. And the summertime gets super busy, yes. I mean, not even summer, but like spring onwards. So we've started notice like influx in tourists last month. I mean, actually you get tourists all year round, but in summer it's insane, but two, it's unbearably hot. That's why, for example, me and my partner, we're gonna go back to like Europe land, hang out in like Budapest and Krakow because it's too hot. So yeah.
Hey,
let's talk
even
more. Yeah. But I love talking about digital nomads, especially if people don't know how to do it. And it's because like the how would you answer, like how do you get into that? I mean, like,
just get a job that you can do remotely.
Yeah, but I mean if someone's never worked in any of those trades, that's what I said. Because I was able to translate my film stuff into marketing, for example. So that's like a good starting point.
Yeah, I mean you have to change your profession.
Your boyfriend looks like a Greek god.
Jesus.
Yeah, he was also...
At least not John Krasinski anymore.
He was called John Krasinski, so he has a nickname John. Yeah.
Why do I feel like your chat is roasting me already?
It's not roasting. Well, you're doing this yourself. you're doing more coffee?
Mm-hmm.
Yes, please. But yeah, he suggested Malta, so we're here because of him. That's so cool that you guys live abroad. Thank you. Yeah, it's awesome. It's sometimes hard because we have to work a lot, you know, for the, like, if you're a digital nomad, sometimes you like have work and then you don't have work. So you have to always be sort of prepared for it. But also I don't recommend people changing countries every month because it really gets annoying, difficult. You do want to like get into habit of having routine and, you know, doing things that you need to do for work essentially. So like gym or having a good place to just go for a walk. So we live next to like a beautiful park, so things like that are important. Yeah. What are you guys' long-term plans? Get married. No, I'm joking. I'm not. Backpacking. Yeah, so we got like big backpacks and we downsize like by a lot. We live like this minimalistic approach to life, or like we have this minimalistic approach to life. We don't have a lot of things. So yeah, for summer, as I mentioned, we're gonna do some Europe tripping, and then at the end of the year, we want to go and travel Asia again.
Maybe I have an idea for a blog post. You should write about like the top 5 professions for digital nomads.
For digital nomads, actually, yeah.
That could be interesting.
Where will you backpack? So we're gonna start with like Northern Italy, because we have a wedding to attend to. Then Switzerland,
not ours.
And then we want to do Poland for a bit. We want to do Budapest for a little bit. Maybe Prague, maybe Berlin. Just hang out in that area because it all depends on the war situation as well. But yeah, then we want to do like Thailand, Philippines, Bali, all that. So we both done it. Before we met, we both traveled to Asia, so we've been there before. But it was more like a holiday. We never actually traveled and worked. So it's going to be interesting to combine those two things. But yeah, we're working on the road. It's quite tricky, but you know, it's fulfilling in some way. John could actually like just, you know, sit and do work 60 hours a week and, you know, he won't be bothered. Whereas I think I get bored after a little while and I need a change of scenery and yeah. I can tell he will propose soon. He kind of already did. It's just, we keep saying it's just formality now. But you'll be the first one to know. What an incredible life you're living. Hey, it took a while to get here. Like a lot of work on myself, on my relationship to things, people. So yeah, it's been like a journey. So trust me, it's not something that comes easy. You really have to freaking work hard for it. And I'm not even saying for job or work, but for your, like, on yourself. Your friend's calling. Make YouTube videos. Yeah, we thought that. We just don't want to, there's a lot of that out there. Not much content on Malta. So we're actually building something that became our like little pet project after us relocating here. You can check it out. It's called Moving Malta, as in M-O-V-I-N Malta, movingmalta.com. So we had an idea to like start it as a real estate project, essentially just because it was so difficult to find something nice to live in. Like there's so many properties, but for example, we needed like extra office space for John. We needed like good location and like stable internet. Huh?
Why are you calling me John?
I don't know, you're like Twitch personality now. So we're gonna stick with John. I like it. So yeah, we started that as like a love-hate project of ours. But then that kind of turned into this, hey, let's make it especially for expats, for digital nomads, like help them relocate here. Because as I said to you, like the whole digital nomading is so, it's not new, but it's like the world isn't ready for it. So we took a spin on that and we did something like this. So yeah, have a look, and we're gonna probably like keep expanding that more and more. We're gonna launch like marketplace sometimes next week. So yeah. But yeah, with video, we also have like we have some ideas how to do it, how to kind of show people how to do it as well. It's not that difficult, so. Thank you. Thanks, eat booty. Eat booty. That's so sweet. But I keep saying, like, if you want to relocate, technically there is nothing stopping you. Of course, there's like visa issues and stuff. I can imagine, like, for example, we would love to see US, and we probably won't be able to do something like that. Maybe South America, but then, yeah, we kind of have an idea of like going to, I don't know, Colombia or something and just grow some weed. But then we're scared of getting murdered.
Oh, that's a new one. I haven't heard that.
You've heard about this. We want to be farmers.
Growing weed?
Yeah, why not?
Nice.
Even if we don't smoke it, we just want to like be farmers. I think farming is really cool. I definitely would like to have chickens and a cow. My goal is Eastern Europe, Croatia, Serbia, Bosnia, cheap living, chill vibes. Yes.
Wait, that's a really strong one.
Thank you.
Maybe too strong.
Perfect. Thank you so much.
I can buy the food.
No. That looks good. It's like watery enough, so that would work. Thank you.
I'm gonna have energy for the stream after this one.
Do I look like I don't have energy? I'm like, it's 9 and I'm almost shaking. Anyway, Greek God delivers coffee. Yeah, I gotta put a ring on it. Morning. Hi, Frost. How are you? I've been to Croatia, again, just on holiday. Croatia is beautiful. This sea is so fascinating. The sea is so highly concentrated with salt that you can't really dive, as in you can dive, but it's so difficult because the sea just pushes you out and you don't want to get that water in your eye, like you'll go blind. It's, yeah. But Serbia, Bosnia, I've never been, but again, very cheap. But you want to look out for the war with Ukraine, how's that going to pan out? But yeah, nothing stopping you from starting digital nomading. Just land yourself a gig. As I said, try to find something that you could potentially be good at or like grow from. Can you hear that? So that's gas being delivered in Malta. So in our area, it's every Thursday, you have this, yep, they're there. You have this huge truck of gas just driving like around the neighborhood, and they just beep to let you know the gas is there. It's so funny. We wanted to go to Romania for a bit, but that's too... No, Romania? Yeah, I think so. We found like a really sweet tiny house and we thought about doing that for a little bit, but yeah, it's too close to the border. I mean, Poland's like right next to border, but I don't know, you know, Poland's a NATO member, sorry. I'm still waking up. So that would be like a bold move if something happened to Poland in that time. But having said that, I know a lot of people living in Poland that are planning to go to US or Canada, like just really escaping because they fear of like a full-blown war. But anyway, that's the politics update. Hello there, Obi-Wan drops in from the ceiling. Hello there. I can't wait for the series, right? It's gonna be so good. What about teaching English? Is that possible? Yeah, that's how I actually started. Oh, I forgot to tell you. Yeah, that's how I started. During the pandemic, that's also when I started really like work with myself, I would say. I quit my job and I built my English teaching business from scratch. So like after a month, I was able to make like a living, my living income. My income living? I don't know how to say that. Yeah, I was able to make my income just solely from teaching English. So you start very low and slow, but then once it grows, it's good. Also, I was teaching people in Switzerland, so obviously that was better money because slightly higher, not slightly, by a lot, hourly rate and stuff. I would suggest you starting like Amazing Talker. So I started Amazing Talker. Then that you have, oh my goodness, there's so many. If you Google like teaching English online, there's so many of them, and it's such an easy way to get into that. And that actually helps you like learn a lot of useful skills like Google Analytics and market, like basis of marketing, because you know you want to like tailor ads and everything to people you're targeting and stuff. So I would definitely start with English teaching. If I mean, everyone's American accent, you know, so you would easily find a job. Also try to target China. Like there is a lot of customer in China and Japan. I had probably most of my students from China and Japan. Almost every single parent in China wants their children to learn English, so it's very, very, very easy. Oh, sorry guys, I chat so much and I never have time. I'm not time, but Russia can invade Poland, NATO will get involved and they can handle that. Yes, exactly. Let's hope that. However, you know, like, as far as we know, Putin is in his fucking, sorry, in his bunker. He can just like give an order. Like everyone's lying to him. He's such a miserable person right now that I don't want to get into that. Yesterday I had like full blown like depression moment because I think I forgot about the war in Ukraine for like a week, and then obviously I got the news about what they did in Wuhan, and that was again like a moment of reflection, like what's the whole point of like doing what we're doing and stuff. But hey, life is good for us. It would be World War III, yeah, but you know, we had previous two, so that's why people are like, it wouldn't be surprising if that happened. Plus, the polls have been waiting door change to wait. Yes, they have. They still feel probably not probably, but still feel a grudge. Plus, their military is absolutely amazing. Like Poland's military is on point in compared to Russia. Like I was saying this to my partner yesterday. Like it's actually ridiculous that Russia just revealed pretty much all their cards, and they're rubbish. They have such a rubbish deck of cards, and yeah. But that's what I mean. If you don't know what else to do, you go into like drastic. You take drastic measures. That's why I'm not putting the World War III off the table yet. Not yet. Damn, this stream be hitting different kind of. Like how you need to be different. Okay, thank you. I'm genuinely impressed and terrified by your name. Yeah, right, it's a good one though. That's such a funny laugh as well. I'm doing right now. Eid booty. So you can teach English online, yes, and it's very lucrative. Just give yourself time, be patient, and research a lot of things like how to market, how to teach, how to you know, plan your classes. Like I was even like making posters and stuff, you know, and like putting them online on Facebook. Like Facebook is huge. Like I, even though I don't teach, I still have one student, I think, because he's a good friend of mine. I still have my, you know, Facebook group active, and you know, I post it every now and then, and it just keeps growing on its own. It's incredible, like the power of social media. So don't underestimate any of that. What else? Good thing Ukraine is kind of winning. Yeah, they're doing good. They showed balls, and I'm so happy because people finally know where Ukraine is. Like, I remember when I moved in to England when I was little. Oh, I should say that I'm Polish. I was born in Poland. But yeah, people were asking me whether Poland had things like washing machine, or they didn't really know where Poland was. But at least now everyone knows where Ukraine is, and yeah, it's really cool. Look up something on YouTube. Yeah, also Reddit. Reddit is pretty cool for that. But Adam something, I'll have a look at that actually. I'm trying to stay away from it because, as I said, if I read some sad, not sad, but like shocking news, it really hits me hard. So that's one thing about the whole war topic. I'm trying not to stay too informed. Like my partner, he's very like deep into it, because he's fascinated by it, but also obviously terrified. But if something significant takes place, he sort of says it to me, but I don't know how to say it. It's not like he sugarcoats it, but a little bit, he says things to me that I should know, I need to know. He doesn't get into details because it really impacts me, like more than others, I think. I don't know. Krasnik, what's your opinion about Green Goblin thing around in the Spider-Man? The Goblin and Therapy. What? I've never heard of it. What's that? So, shock. I am a Star Wars girl, as you guys probably can notice. I am not massively into Marvel, but I was very impressed with Spider-Man. Like the latest one into the Spider-Verse. It was just... not into Spider-Verse, that was the cartoon, which I also love. That was incredible. Was it? Wait. Spider-Man into the Spider-Verse, yes. No Way Home. I was really impressed with that. We even reviewed. Very well, like in the world, cruelty and stuff. It's so crazy that people are capable of like hurting one another to this extent, and it's not just war, but like, you know, there's so many different psychopaths out there. Having said that, I know we all are capable of doing something like this. And that thought is even more frightening, probably, knowing that anyone is capable of doing that if exposed to the right thing, if taught the right thing, yeah, it's crazy to think that. Coffee. Yum. I love my black coffees. That's actually a sign of maturity, I think. The moment you start drinking black coffee and you stop drinking red wine. I used to be obsessed with red wine from like very young age. I lived in Paris as well, so like I loved Paris. But yeah, now I'm almost 30 and yeah, I'm into my white wine. I really like a nice Riesling or like something very citrusy, like it cannot be too sweet, but like citrusy refreshing, like Rieslings are really good. Like Germany and like Switzerland, they have some really awesome Riesling, and Austria, oh my God, Austrian wine, it's solid. Being 30 is great. Yeah, it's like a whole new approach. Like, I read it somewhere that 30 is new 20, and I so like agree with that. It's so cringe, but there is something to it. I've never felt better in my life, like mentally. And it's not just today, you know, or recently. I have been on like a streak with love and positivity and just acceptance of like me, my place within this world, my body, my face, you know, like, yeah, I love it. Are you 30, buddy? Just turned 30. Happy birthday. Oh, Ukraine. Ah, you're most welcome. I still haven't replied. Oh my God. Life is long, enjoy every moment. A lot can happen, even in just a year. Amen. That's so true. It's like last year in April, where was I? Yeah, we were in Switzerland. I was very unhappy, but no, actually last year in April, that was when we decided to move to Malta. We went hiking and me and my partner, we started chatting and we were playing this with this idea back and forth. My first thought was like, oh no, I need to take all my plans. We need to somehow like transfer it. And no, I ended up selling everything, literally everything. We just left some clothes. We stored our hiking and camping gear at my partner's brother's basement, essentially, and we have a futon as well. If you don't have a futon, get a futon. Best night's sleep. That's it. We sold everything. Like, everything you see here, it's not ours. It belongs to the house, and So that's actually one of the cool things about Malta, that most of the places come furnished and like well equipped with like knives, glasses, pots, pans, so we didn't need to buy any of that. But a lot of countries is just, in a lot of countries, it's an empty space. So in Switzerland, we had to give, when we gave up our apartment, we had to get rid of everything. Even though we like fully equipped the apartment, we couldn't leave anything in, nothing for the next person. They just wanted it like in this sterile state. It was very painful to watch because of the whole waste. So like I sold things, but I also had to throw away some things, and that was so traumatizing for me that I think that's when I finally put like a big fat line under the whole consuming, buying, acquiring. I was like, fuck it, I'm just minimalist now. And yeah, and I have been ever since. Don't shop for things if you don't need them. But again, I cannot tell people how to live. It's more like I can just tell you and show you how I do it. Thank you for following. Amun-Ra? Is it the Amun-Ra? Crazy.